Every Samsung Galaxy smartphone confirmed to receive the One UI 8.5 update. The One UI 8 deployment has come to a close. The last device, the Galaxy Tab A 9 Plus, has finally received the update, and it is currently in development and will be based on Android 16. It is scheduled to debut with the S26 series early next year, followed by a phased release to previous flagships, foldables, tablets, and midrange Galaxy devices. So, what's new in One UI 8.5? The introduction of several visual and functional improvements across the system. According to early firmware builds, One UI 8.5 will bring 1. A highly adjustable quick panel where users can move or remove practically any toggle or card. 2. A new search bar placed to the bottom of apps like settings for better one-handed reach. 3. Improved protection for sensitive information when sharing images. 4. Updated Samsung internet browser with smoother UI and performance improvements. 5. 3D style app icons with shadows and depth for a fresh visual look. 6. New non-text navigation symbols inside system apps. 7. 3 new lock screen clock styles. 8. Improved always-on display animation that starts from the exact point of touch. 9. An upgraded Galaxy AI Now brief feature that doubles as a quick flashlight shortcut. The One UI 8.5 beta program is planned to commence in late November, followed by the stable release in early 2026. Samsung's upgrade policy makes it straightforward to determine eligibility. Any device set to receive Android 16 or previously confirmed for One UI 8.0 is also expected to receive One UI 8.5. Hate Now briefs music recommendations. One UI 8.5 could provide a fix. Samsung introduced Now Brief with the S25 and expanded it to the S24 with the One UI 8.0 update. However, not all its features worked as well as Samsung advertised. Spotify and YouTube recommendations, in particular, were far from being usable. Samsung is planning to improve these with One UI 8.5. After using Now Brief, numerous customers reported that Spotify and YouTube recommendations were nowhere close to what they would like to see. Most recommended Spotify playlists and YouTube videos were overly general and not based on a user's tastes or viewing history. So, Samsung appears to be working to improve the feature with One UI 8.5. Android Authority study states One UI 8.5's code includes text strings that explain how Samsung is boosting Spotify and YouTube recommendations in Now Brief. It will recommend YouTube videos depending on sports teams that you are interested in. It will also recommend videos based on your scheduled vacations, favorite videos, and more. It will request your permission to track your likes. Now Brief will also recommend Spotify playlists based on the day, time, and weather. For example, it can recommend music playlists when it is your birthday week. It can also recommend playlists at the start of the week, end of the week, a New Year playlist, a rainy day playlist, a snowy day playlist, and even a playlist that includes songs you've listened to the most this year. Samsung will also improve Now Brief by incorporating photo sharing recommendations to it. For example, it will promote sharing photographs with your family members and friends when it finds them in your phone's gallery app. It can also recommend profile photographs and relationships for contacts, based on photos found in the gallery app. Adaptive clock not working on One UI 8? Samsung says it has a fix. This One UI 8 exclusive was broken for users, but there's an easy remedy. One UI 8 includes a unique feature for Samsung phones that dynamically alter the lock screen clock settings to fit your wallpaper. It's called Adaptive Clock. It controls font size, orientation, and location based on your lock screen wallpaper. However, people have noted for months that Adaptive Clock hasn't been working as promised, as recorded by Reddit postings and comments. Now, Samsung is finally here with a simple repair that simply takes upgrading an app. We have confirmed that the Adaptive Clock, Stretch Clock, feature does not function properly on Galaxy devices running One UI 8 if the GoodLock Lockstar app has not been updated to version 7.01.10, Samsung said in a community post. Update the GoodLock Lockstar app to version 7.01.10 through the Galaxy Store. GoodLock is the home for different apps and modules that enable granular control over the One UI 8 software experience. One module is Lockstar, and it administers the lock screen, and the adaptive clock function by extension. Samsung recognized the adaptive clock difficulties as being caused by obsolete Lockstar Good Lock applications. Adaptive time works by recognizing the subject of your wallpaper and updating your time preferences accordingly. As long as consumers update to version 7.01.10 or higher, was published a few months ago, they'll be able to use adaptive clock as planned. How to upgrade the Lockstar Good Lock module. To update Lockstar, open the Galaxy Store and navigate to the hamburger menu. From there, hit the Updates tab and pick Lockstar, following the on-screen steps to complete the upgrade. If they're not already installed on your device, you may need to download Good Lock and the Lockstar module from the Galaxy Store. Once you have Lockstar version 7.01.10 or newer up and running, adaptive clock will work correctly with supported wallpapers. Ideally, you should pick wallpapers with easily identifiable subjects for the maximum chance of success. Samsung's adaptive clock update for One UI 8 comes as the company is apparently finalizing a One UI 8.5 beta program for December. The One UI 8.5 is currently under development, and it will supposedly have various new features. The official launch date for the One UI 8 beta upgrade is likely to be December 8. This marks the beginning of the beta program, where users can check out the new features and submit feedback before the general release. After that, the corporation will reportedly issue two more beta releases. One UI 8.5 Beta 2 is slated to debut on December 22, while Beta 3 will follow on January 5. It means that following that, we can expect a stable upgrade. One UI 8.5 may give longer battery life by minimizing network consumption. The leaked One UI 8.5 firmware indicates a feature called Network Battery Saver, which can limit network usage to offer longer battery backup. Samsung's next Android customization for Galaxy phones and tablets, One UI 8.5, was expected to be a modest update. However, as we are diving more into the leaked One UI 8.5 firmware for the S25 Ultra, it is turning out to be a substantial one, with tiny UI tweaks that make a huge influence on the overall design of the program. Well, it appears like it will also bring more than just visual changes, such as a handy ability to preserve battery. Android Authority has discovered strings of code in One UI 8.5 that indicate a new feature named Network Battery Saver. This feature can identify when your phone is not in use, such as when you are sleeping, and limit the network usage, helping minimize the battery drain and enabling a longer battery backup. To detect if the phone is in use or not, and to determine your usage pattern, this function employs personal data intelligence. Since personal data intelligence already understands your phone usage pattern, Samsung is leveraging it for Network Battery Saver. This function could drastically improve battery drain while you aren't using the gadget. There are at least three strings of code explaining the feature. The first states, save battery by limiting network performance when your phone isn't likely to be used, such as when you're sleeping. The second states, Network Battery Saver uses personal data intelligence to determine when to apply network performance limits, such as when you're at home or when you're unlikely to use your phone. You can configure the apps and services that use personal data intelligence in settings. The third reads, to use Network Battery Saving, turn on personal data intelligence in settings. So that's all we know for now. We'll be sure to keep you updated as soon as we have more information. Thanks for watching.